Hey, and welcome back to another Animal Crossing video. Today is a very special video because it is a community-focused one. That means it includes all of your incredible designs for this week's Paradise post. We voted for Fauna on this week, and you all created some absolutely beautiful designs that I'm very excited to show off. If you want to join in on this upcoming week, be sure to check out the community panel, where we will be voting today for this week's upcoming character design. So, let's get started. First up, we have Delauder's entry. They have this nice soft lighting with beautiful striped walls, and it has an incredibly elegant design and vibe. The pink rose rug complements nicely against the white for the furniture and walls, and I love that you use the string lights in the front of the grand piano to make a separate space for her to perform. There's even a grand entry rug going all the way from the entryway to the stage. I love this other photo with your villager dressed up in the rose shirt to match the environment, and it also looks like there's a harp in the background and some cookies to enjoy in the little office space on the side. What's really cool about this is not only does she have a bit of a concert area, but a separate living space with her own upright piano to practice on her free time. There's a little kitchenette in a bedroom space, and you can really see the attention to detail and love that they put in for Fauna's quaint piano home. Next up, we have Meadowlark, who submitted a video. We get to see this beautiful exterior of Fauna's home, which includes a cozy garden area with some string lights where she can enjoy reviewing her sheet music. I love the lanterns on the ground, and they match the ones that are included with the string lights themselves. And as we head inside, we get to see something really unique, but absolutely beautiful. It's a small room, but focused entirely on the grand piano. It has nice ivy and elegant items like plants and pots on the side, and beautiful paintings on the wall. It almost feels like a gallery where you can sit and enjoy the sounds of the piano playing. The layering of this build is really clever, definitely something to get inspired from for future builds. For their next room, you can see her private bedroom and cozy living area, complete with a beautiful couch and a fireplace. I love how you use the partition walls, the pillars, and the counters to divide up the space. It's definitely a really relaxing spot to be after a big performance downstairs. This next one is actually created in Harv's Island, which is completely awesome to do if you do not have her amiibo card or have her on your Paradise Island, so feel free to always post any build you have, whether it's on Happy Home Paradise or in Harv's Island. So Man has created this cozy home for Fauna using lots of warm tones that go really well with Fauna's style. There's this nice accent wall of roses and a cozy, vibrant rug in the sitting area. With the partitions and separate spaces, it has a bit of a studio apartment thing going on, and it works really well if she was a music artist and performer in like a big city. The rest of the plants around the room add a pop of green in the rest of the yellows and browns, which is a really nice contrast for the whole room. Now we have Zentin's design. With a concert hall on top of an evening hill, it has a super approachable atmosphere, and the villagers look pretty eager to get into. I love the use of the bubble blowers and the lights at the bottom of the cliff. It really adds a little bit of dynamic lighting in the evening. As you enter inside, you get a view of the classy concert hall with the huge arched windows and plenty of seating to enjoy the show. The accent wall with the ivy and the pictures are a great backdrop to the stage where Fauna performs. The chandeliers on top give us an extra flair of that elegance as the villagers who support the concert go and enjoy the show. Overall, the composition of this room is just absolutely stunning. Another great design made in Harv's Island for Fauna is by Gabby. We have this really pretty forest cabin feel to it with the hanging flowers, mushroom lamps, and flower field flooring. I love the use of the sunflower rug and the mums to create a cozy sitting area for tea. There are some sweet gyroids on the wall to accompany the harp and upright piano that you can see, and another pretty rose rug. I just love how everything in this home ties together so nicely with the forest theme, and it's really a perfect spot for the sweet deer to enjoy the sounds of nature mixed with their music. There's a bit of a new vibe with this design by Colorless Canvas, and I'm a sucker for blues, and this home for Fauna has it. The exterior is really beautiful, setting amongst the ruins, and early morning vibe gives us really nice glow. The roof and the gazebo roof matches alongside the waterfalls, and it contrasts nicely against the bright sand pathing on the ground. Inside, it has a cool lounge vibe with a private sitting area in the back, some nice table settings to sit and enjoy, and a relaxing bar to grab a beverage while listening to music. I love that the piano is visible from everywhere in this room. The mood lighting really sets the stage for a great show. The way that Colorless used a partition as a protruding wall flat against the wall near the piano is a really cool concept, and the shelving on the side of it looks really great. It's just a really incredible overall design, and I would definitely want to come to this piano lounge after a long day. Next up, we have Gavin, aka Ghost Kids Design. So outside, they have a nice springtime setting with some cherry blossom trees, a beautiful little fountain, and a cute house that kind of matches Fauna's look with the brown bricks and the pinkish red roof. As you go inside, you get a nice beautiful concert hall with a little cityscape in the background as the accent wall, and you have these really cute cherry blossom fake trees to kind of match the outside that we saw earlier. You have a nice row of chairs to sit on and enjoy the show, as well as some nice plants to kind of liven up the environment a little bit. It's a really nice overall design and very symmetrical. Next up is DJ Bella Coco's design with a gorgeous night scene. Fauna is dressed for the occasion, and you could buy tickets on the booth outside on the left. I love that there's pathways through the garden and a relaxing bench to enjoy the night sky. The pops of pink and orange flowers on the bushes in the garden really tie the whole environment together. As you walk inside, you're struck with a brilliant white piano against some pretty red curtains as an accent wall. I love that the arch windows keep making a comeback because they just fit this theme so well. The classy chandeliers can be seen hanging from the ceilings, as well as some floral swag for decoration. One thing that DJM did in this design that I absolutely adore is the little tables with cookies and tea to enjoy while watching Fauna play. It's just really nice placement and a really nice choice of snacks. After that, we have a little bit of a different scene where Masquerade has chosen the winter scene for Fauna, and you can see a beautiful little exterior with a harp outside and the gazebo. I love this gazebo item, and I love the use of flowers outside as well as the bushes that are pink versus the white flowers that are lining the pathway. After you go inside, you can see a nice rich red with bright pops of color in yellow for the rug and just a beautiful grand piano. Fauna's wearing a black tuxedo dress, which is just super cute, and it just looks really nice overall. We do get a sneak peek upstairs of her private living quarters, where you can see a very elegant bed, as well as a nice bathroom area, a fireplace, and some really beautiful mood lighting. It's also nice that you get to see the outdoor snow that we saw earlier, but from the inside through the windows. And continuing with our winter theme, we have a design by Tigress Angel, who has created a beautiful winter scene with the apple trees. You can see some holly bushes and a nice pathway that kind of goes up through the ropes up into the little cabin. I love the side stage area outside to the right, where it's surrounded by twinkly lights, but there's also a really cozy campfire. After heading inside, we see this really nice scene of Fauna playing with Megan by her side to listen. There's some other instruments like a saxophone and a clarinet maybe, and there's a really nice sitting area for everybody to enjoy where they can pick up some cakes or snacks, and definitely looks a little bit steamy and warm, which is much needed after the winter outside. From another angle, you do see backstage there is a cozy tiny little bedroom, so you have a nice private changing area, and it's really cute with the splashes of pink against all the brown elegant stuff on the outside. So this one by Pendles, I definitely needed to have the entirety of just this whole thing in here because it's absolutely incredible, but it's hosted on Imgur and it's 1,000 miles. So you have Fauna standing in her room, you know, with all of her things, and she's making her way downtown. And there she is playing the piano, and there's a lot of junk in her house. Walking fast, faces pass. And she's homebound. I just thought that was pretty incredible and I needed to share that entire thing. But there it is. There's her shot of her inside her house. You just did a fantastic job, Pendles. I love this. It totally cracked me up. Composition is great. I had to include the entire Imgur site because it was just so worth it. But thank you so much for your submission. And there you have it. Those are the designs for this week's Paradise post. And you guys did an incredible job. All of these came out so, so nice. And I couldn't be happier just seeing all the creativity that's gone into these builds. If you guys like this video, consider booping that like button and let us know which one has been your favorite out of all of these incredibly talented Animal Crossing creators. So thank you guys so much. I also want to give a quick thank you to my patrons and members for always supporting the channel. You guys are incredible and I super duper appreciate you with all my heart. I also want to have a huge thank you to everybody who submitted their designs. We do submit these in the weekly Paradise Room in my Discord, which is in the description, or you can tag me in a YouTube or a Twitter post is fine too, using the hashtag weekly Paradise post. But thank you guys again. I hope you really enjoyed and got some inspiration for Fauna's build, and I will see you guys on the next video. Bye!